Good afternoon, guys. Today we're doing Marshall's Men a little later because I had client work this morning. Just finished up with training one of my apprentices in the closure technique. So I'll bring more healing to the world, more healing to you guys to actually get resolution on that trauma, right? That's the power of the closure technique, is it eliminates trauma. So, and you don't have to believe me, you can actually ask people that and they'll tell you straight up that it does that. So this week, it's been an interesting week. Didn't do any video trainings, did some written ones for you guys. Because that was more in alignment with my lightness, with the expansiveness, for with my energy. It's more creative. I'm better at writing than I am with video in a lot of ways. And so I'm just kind of playing with those things. But that's where kind of that creativity is coming from. And really this week was about a sharp clarity in getting what I call congruent. Now, I've talked about this a little bit over the last several episodes, Marshall's Minute, and we did an experiment this week on getting congruent. Where are we feeling heavy? What pain are we tolerating? What are we avoiding in our happiness? Because fundamentally, my goal here with y'all, with all of us, is for us to break free codependency so we can move to the next step, which is to become aligned with congruency. And congruency is a result of being embodied in our value. This is the trick. And value isn't something we earn. It's value is something we experience. And it's typically experienced in a lightness or a really strong sense of well-being and center that then inspires us to take action, that inspires us to receive things, and it guides us. Because life isn't necessarily a logical machine, it's more of an emotional experience we have. And if we're really to get out there and do something brilliant with our lives, which is, it's nothing to do with codependency, but has everything to do with being us, right? Being who we are, then we gotta tap into this idea of congruency. So for the last several episodes, it's been about awareness, building into that. What am I becoming aware of for myself and others? And congruency is this week's big awareness. It's like, where am I congruent? Where am I not? And I had to get honest with myself, and changes came about with several things in my life within hours of getting aligned with that congruency that made sense. It's like, yep, this is what we need to do. This is where we need to go. This is what we need to change. Oh, look, that's changing itself for me. I didn't even have to address that. It's a profound thing that starts happening when we get aligned with ourselves, because relationships, money, happiness, health, purpose, inspiration, energy change. They start behaving in a way that's really easy for us, really joyful for us, and very inspiring for us. And that's what I've discovered this week, is a lot more congruency, or the need to be more congruent with me in a lot of different areas. Relationships, money, with how I market myself, how I work with you guys, the materials I put out, things like that. Congruency over force specifically, because I realized this week that I had a lot of unconscious forcing going on. I have to do this, and should do that, and must be this, and must be that. And that's exhausting work. And so I had to get in contact with that, really kind of bring a lot of awareness around it, and then start asking the question, what is congruent beyond this? And typically with force, the congruency tends to be openness. We stop trying to control things. We start learning to receive what's showing up for us. And that's kind of the magic here with congruency. There isn't this forceful effort involved that leads to burnout. Instead, there's this energized effort that leads to success and fulfillment. You know, it leads to getting what we want, what we desire. And it's really unexpectedly and kind of profoundly easy. Like, there just isn't this pressure in it. There's just this lightness to it. Guys, this is where we're going. This is my big goal with all of this, is to move into that space with, there's a lot of face things, the emojis there. It's to move into this because we're not codependent as identities or as people. Codependency is that survival mechanism we've been enduring, right? That's how we survive the narcissistic discard and survive the consumer supply relationship and all that. We get beyond that. It's really about a willful creation in our life. It's this chance to be us in a way that's easy, that doesn't require other people to be pleased. It doesn't need anybody to be a certain way. It doesn't demand us to be a certain way. Rather, it's for us to understand where we're coming from and to choose where we want to end up from a sense of deep well-being. Okay, that's been a big thing this week, Marshall. Where are you being well-being? Where are you not? Where am I putting myself that I'm tolerating pain and discord or lack of harmony or congruence or alignment? Where am I being aligned? Very challenging questions for me because it's requiring me to look at what I'm trying to control and then release the control on those things and receive what shows up instead. And we'll see where this goes. I have some hunches where it's going to take me. But this is it. Guys, when we leave codependency, we leave that realm of trying to survive, we get aligned with our value, then we can get aligned with our awareness, which leads to congruency. We get to do things we didn't think we were going to do. Okay? Pretty powerful. Like, for instance, that sorry quick list, when to say sorry, when to not say sorry. That is something that I'd always wanted something to go viral. It was one of my personal goals. I had no idea how to make it work. I still don't. But that thing went viral after I made space for... I didn't even know that would go viral. I just had this idea that I think it'd be cool to have something go viral. Boom, it went viral. That's what I'm talking about. Something as simple as that can be applied to your relationships, money, career, purposes. When we get out of our stories, we get out of the bullshit we talk to ourselves about how difficult a thing must be or what we must be doing to make it work or what's going to be required. We actually tune into what it takes or what our intuition is and the energy around it is. Then these things become very simple and very easy for us to accomplish. This is where people really, you know, you've likely seen people where they go from like 0 to 100 like that in their lives. This is where they hit it. They hit that congruency, and then suddenly things just started popping for them. Things got much, much easier for them. And so that's where we're going with this. That's where I'm going, at least. And if you want to follow, keep watching. So this week, my big discoveries are this. We always need to return back to awareness and check in with our congruency. Check in with where we're coming from, well-being, what pain we're tolerating, and then get back into that stillness of receiving so that we can receive our inspiration and see what we need to do, what we want to do from that point of view, and then take action on it as inspired. That's been the big, 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 big message to me. The other one is that it's time to stop absorbing and just let it go. I've had a habit of trying to put myself in the middle of things a lot, and I don't have to do that anymore. I don't have to carry it anymore. And so that's really a deeper level of just release for me. It's like, oh, let's leave it in their yard. And to really exercise that, not just mentally, but emotionally, leave it in their yard. It's a lot of freedom coming in from that. So that is the discoveries that have been coming in this week for me. With congruency plus awareness equals ease. Things are just moving without a whole lot of effort. And it's very inspiring and exciting to see what's coming. So we'll discuss more of this unfolds. If you want master training in this and actually taking it and applying it to your life, then keep your eye out for the Brilliance Mastermind. It will open up in November. I only open it once a year. I was going to open it up in August, but I'm like, we're going to do this once a year. Opens up in November for 2 weeks for enrollment. It's a flat fee. The fee is $2,000, or you can enroll for $199 a month. But we go through a 12-week in-depth process that gets you into this, and then we start running you through experiments through each month after that 12-week training. So this is where you master that. highly recommend doing Codependence to Confidence and Get Closure Now before you do that, so that you don't have trauma interfering and that you're well on your way to freedom from your codependence. Okay, guys? I appreciate you being in the group. I appreciate you guys supporting each other. And thank you for referring people to the group, to the programs, for giving your trust, a little trust in me and your vulnerability, and for promoting me, for sharing me with other people. That helps me accomplish one of my big goals, which is impact and purpose for people, helping people connect with their brilliance. Because, guys, we're not flawed. We're not broken. We're brilliant. Now we can use that brilliance to do things and have things that we really want. So I appreciate that. Thank you. You guys have a great weekend, and I will see you guys next week. Okay. Bye-bye, guys.